say that the bank was set on fire.
News just breaking in the past few hours. Eurozone finance ministers have reached a deal.
And I'm fully aware of how difficult the present situation is for the Greek people.
Shops are closed because of these austerity measures.
If you have to prove that you're credit worthy, well, it seems as though your credit has already long gone.
We've seen the violent clashes breaking out again between the riot police and the protesters. I'll just show you what's happening at the front of the Parliament building still. You've got protesters throwing Molotov cocktails towards the riot police. We've seen tear gas already being used.
And foreigners over the austerity program, ordinary people, civil servants feel they're the ones having to pay.
It's others who should be, particularly politicians, it seems, today. And we have been told that first.
When the financial crisis struck in 2008, Thessaloniki, Greece's second largest city, was forced to face drastic economic and social hardships. Unemployment has risen to 26%, GDP shrank by 6% in 2012, and wages have almost halved. But in order to grasp the true impact of the crisis, the struggle of the everyday citizen, in contrast with the nation as a whole, must be understood.
I think that Greece, and especially the Greek state, was living above its means for at least 15, 20 years.
I think it was inevitable, and I think we knew it, but we didn't want to accept it.
It was obviously foreseen, and obviously was bad management from the government. Obviously, a lot of uncontrollable loans from banks to people who obviously had no idea how to handle that cash.
Left us spending more than we could spend.
You have your life secured with an income, not big enough, probably. You never become rich with a salary, but very safe.
Γιατί πριν από αυτό, οι άνθρωποι ήταν όλοι, σχεδόν έλεγες, όλοι ήταν πλούσιοι. Δηλαδή έπαιρναν δάνεια, παραδείγματος χάρη, και έπαιρνε ο καθένας το τάδε αυτοκίνητο. Δηλαδή ζούσαν σε μια μη ρεαλιστική, μη πραγματική ζωή σε σχέση με τις οικονομικές δυνατότητες που είχαν.
And then, one day, the debt was so high that the foreign investors told we cannot give anymore.
Whereas the causes of the recession are generally agreed upon, the social changes affecting many Greek people are often overlooked by the public.
The results first, unemployment is the worst result.
And its family, it's happy if it has one member employed so far, which is, it's very hard.
Well, the biggest result of this crisis, and the biggest problem of this crisis is unemployment.
The stores, it's Tsimiskisti. Are closing one after another.
Now you see people starving in the streets, like people searching in the garbage to find something to eat. You see children in school. You see businessmen in a very difficult position, like successful businessmen that still have their business, but they are, you know, struggling to survive. It's like, I don't know, everything got much more difficult for everybody. And I believe that especially middle class, and they're struggling, and maybe they will disappear as a class, I don't know.
The issue of a declining middle class was mentioned by many individuals who believed that losing this entire social class could further harm the Greek society.
The biggest social change is that obviously we had a better life. You had the middle class living like the upper class living like Million Dollar Man. All that has changed. That has changed totally. The middle class is poor now, and you have the rich class, it's gone down to the middle class. They always lived the upper class life. So you have the middle class trying to live the upper class life, and everybody's like at one level now.
It's a fact ότι δεν υπάρχει πλέον middle class. Έχει αυξηθεί ο ιδιότητα των νέων φτωχών, όπως λέμε, new poor people. Γιατί είναι ακριβώς αυτοί που έχουν χάσει τη δουλειά τους, έχουν χάσει τα πάντα σχεδόν και νομίζω ότι αν τη συνεχίσει δεν θα ξαναυπάρξει κιόλας.
The middle class does not exist anymore. So there are only poor people and rich people. There was a big middle class, but now they don't exist.
This is a phenomenon that's happening all over the world. It's pretty much the same. And I think that because Greeks have a very high educational level and they have a very good practical skills, I think that the middle class will find its way and come back again.
There are many NGOs across Greece trying to help struggling families. One such organization is Smile of a Child.
It's actually the creation of a 10-year-old child, Andreas Yiannopoulos, as you saw in the video. Andreas was very sick, he had cancer, and in his journal he wrote that he wanted to form an organization that would help all children in need. It became a national effort, so all Greece united to form this organization.
Smile of a Child have 12 community homes throughout Greece, supporting almost 300 children. Even though they primarily work with helping children, they also try to provide food and clothing to households in need.
We support families and children with welfare problems, with food, clothes, toys, everything a family needs. We can also provide psychological support or counseling or social services, so as all the family problems can be solved. Our goal is to help this family
stand
on its feet.
Stand on its feet
and move on.
Since 2008, do you think it's gotten better, or is there still more and more families coming for help? Still, there's no
better. Although outside Greece people have the perception that the crisis is receding, the reality is that the Greek people feel as though they remain in the eye of the storm.
I don't think, me personally, I believe we're at the worst part, but people haven't realized that yet. I think people are basically in a coma.
Right now we're at the final stage of financial crisis where nobody hopes for anything. The psychology of the local people is below zero. They feel that the country will never recover. They're extremely unhappy. And I cannot blame them for that.
We haven't seen the results yet. They say that they are doing an effective job, but we haven't seen the results yet as citizens in the city of Thessaloniki. Huh? Some good stuff have been made, we see them, but otherwise there are no big differences.
Γιατί πολλοί κόσμος λέει ότι θα κάνουμε investment, θα έρθουμε, αλλά δεν φαίνεται αυτό το πράγμα να ξεκινάει και αυτό λίγο με φοβίζει. Γενικά είμαι αισιόδοξη, αλλά είμαι λίγο περιορισμένα αισιόδοξη.
So is this like a general feel among the people that nothing is really happening?
It is. People don't believe in what they hear from the government and even from the outside,
είναι πολύ
απεσιόδοξη.
Και αυτό ακόμα δεν θα κρατήσει ακόμα την ανάπτυξη κάτω.
In general, I'm optimistic as a person, αλλά εντάξει, not so much anymore. Γιατί πρέπει να υπάρχει η δυνατότητα της ανάπτυξης και δεν ακούμε πολλά, αλλά δεν βλέπουμε κάτι.
Αλλά φαίνεται ότι σιγά σιγά, τουλάχιστον σαν κράτος, η Ελλάδα θα πάει καλύτερα.
They say that from 2014 business will come back as it was, but step by step, you know, very slowly. I think it will take us 5 years or more to get back to previous situation.
Definitely is hope.
No one is sure of where the crisis will go or where it will end. While the Greek financial crisis may have been forgotten around the world, the people of Greece are still feeling the effects, with many believing that the worst stage of the crisis continues to cause problems across Greece.
Countries don't die, and economies, they go through cycles, and I think that in a couple of years' time, things are going to be much better, but not so far.
It will be wrong to say that the crisis is going to finish, and that we are going back to the period before 2009. We'll never go back there.